of America. Just for my curiosity, have you heard about Amja? Can I see some hands? Amja? Have you heard about Amja Fiqh Council? The Assembly of Majma Fuqaha al-Sharia of America? No? Sisters? Okay. We do actually hold imams training on an annual basis, and we choose particular, like, you know, specific topic. We discuss it actually in depth, and we come up with recommendations. This is actually our human effort. We might be right, we might be wrong, Allahu A'lam. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that we do not issue any fatwa or declaration without doing our due diligence, without spending a lot of time and effort and money in order for us to investigate and to find out, you know, that whatever we post actually is the most correct opinion to the utmost of our ability. We did our own research on those five several companies, and actually we invited them back in 2014 to come and to do a presentation in front of us, in front of the fatwa committee, to see what kind of model they have. And we do have like copies from their contracts. We did not ask for those copies. Actually, Muslims in the US, I mean, ask us as members in the fatwa committee, and they share the contract of guidance, residential, and la riba, and they ask us, do you think that this is halal or haram? And they make it clear, do not give me details. I'm a very common individual. Do not tell me some technical, tell me that this contract is halal, so you go for it, and this contract actually is haram, avoid it. So we try to keep it as simple as possible. If you Google Amja Islamic Mortgage Companies, you will see a declaration written in both in Arabic and in English. As I said, I mean, after like listening to the presentation of the Sharia board members of those companies, or whosoever actually has Sharia advisory board, and after doing our own analysis and our own investigation, our own research, we came up with the following: that the best option again is Amin housing. Amin housing is not available for everybody. Right after that, guidance residential. Guidance residential actually goes with a very simple model called diminishing partnership. Al-Musharaka, Al-Mutanaqisa, Al-Muntahiya, Bit-Tamlik, diminishing partnership. Which means that they buy the property jointly with you, and they ask for as minimal as 5% where you can join. Of course, you have to be qualified to join guidance residential for financing. They check your credit history and your employment history and your income. Once you are qualified, you need to come up with at least 5% to buy the house jointly with guidance residential. In the same agreement, you agree both with them that you will be renting their share. So you start with 5% and guidance residential 95%. And, you know, since you occupy the property and start using it, you start renting those 95% and buying their shares gradually, month by month. So you start 5%, 95%. Maybe next month you become 6% owner versus 94%, 7%, 93%, all the way until you kick them out of the deal by being the 100% owner, and they are the zero owner in this project or this agreement between you and them. We did actually, you know, analyze and study, you know, deeply this contract. Some of us in the fatwa committee were with the impression that in the past, maybe for the last 10 years before 2014, we were with the impression that, you know, this model actually is not Sharia compliant enough. After some, you know, verification with Mufti Taqi Uthmani through our, you know, the president of Amja, Dr. Hussein Hamid Hassan, we found out that the model or the structure of this agreement actually is reasonable enough, like could be tolerated, called Sharikatul Milk instead of Sharikatul Aqd. It's a long story. Long story short, dealing with this company actually is reasonable enough. Yani if you want to buy a house for residential purposes, then have a peace of mind and just finance your house with this company. You are not committing anything haram. You are not getting involved in riba. There are certain scenarios where guidance residential actually does share the profit and loss with you, certain scenarios. And that's actually enough to permit the transaction, providing that they put their name on the title as an owner, along with yourself as a customer. And as I said, you start buying their share and renting the rest of their shares until you kick them out of the deal by becoming the 100% owner, and they are the 0% owner. There are some glitches in the contract here or there when it comes to property tax, when it comes to maintenance, when it comes to insurance. They have their own justification on why they do not want to share those expenses. Although, I mean, if you want to go with the ideal situation, if you want to go with the book, if we are partners, then we have to share the expenses. They said, well, you are the one who is occupying the property. So the property tax actually is utilized for the service of the resident himself. We are not living there. I mean, you enjoy the streets and the parks and the police, you know, department and the public school system. All these different services are funded, you know, by the property tax. If you are the one who is living there, then you take care of your own tax. Is that something, you know, reasonable? I mean, does have, you know, some logic behind it? Yes, actually, it does. Okay. Even if we agree that their approach is wrong 100%, okay, just go with the worst case scenario, that they have to share their percentage of the tax. Being waived or excusing themselves from paying the property tax does not render the whole agreement to be an interest-bearing one. Because the most important thing is what? Is the ownership. The most important thing is the ownership. And the ownership actually is there. Prophet ﷺ said, Al-Kharaju bil-Daman, Al-Kharaju bil-Daman, which means that profit follows liability. Do they make profit? Of course they make. Okay. Do they take some risk up to certain limit? Yes, I mean, they take some risk. Within the given circumstances, as Muslims living in the U.S., providing that other Islamic alternatives are not as genuine, as sound, as legitimate, as guided residential, we reached to a conclusion as a fatwa committee that, you know, this company is reasonable enough. As a matter of fact, some of us, including myself, we finance our own homes with guidance residential. After that, I mean, I'm going in order. Number one, are you following up with me? Number one is Amin Housing. And number two is guidance residential. And then we have number three. We have two different companies who are in the same level. Again, to the utmost of our ability, we might be right, we might be wrong. We might change our mind in the same way that we change our mind when it comes to guidance residential. We keep saying that guidance is not allowed for maybe 10 years. And then we discovered that we were mistaken. There is a way to justify it. And we change our mind with the pleasure, actually. We do not have any issue, you know, or anything personal against those companies. However, we have been entrusted by our community to, you know, declare whatever we believe is correct. So to the utmost of our ability, guidance residential is a very reasonable option. If you want to buy a house, go with this option without even having hesitance or reluctance that you are doing something haram or something wrong. After that,